Recently, I've been getting a lot of comments asking my thoughts about how the presidential election will play out this year. So, after doing research and preparation for this video, I found an interesting report which I think does a solid job of outlining various scenarios that will likely play out. In June 2020, the Transition Integrity Project convened a bipartisan group of over 100 current and former senior government and campaign leaders and other experts in a series of 2020 election crisis scenario planning exercises. These roughly 100 individuals game-roomed five main scenarios, just like the Pentagon does in its war room. The results of all five tabletop exercises were alarming. They concluded that there was an extremely high degree of likelihood that November's elections will be marked by a chaotic legal and political landscape, violence in the streets, and a constitutional crisis like we've never faced in our country before. The days between November 3rd and at a minimum to Inauguration Day on January 20th could be the most challenging days our nation will ever face. In some scenarios, the unraveling of the United States completely and a power struggle is a real possibility. Will these 78 days between election night and Inauguration Day be America's last days? In this video, we will look at the five scenarios explored by this bipartisan group and explore ways we can prepare ourselves to survive through the chaos. Please consider subscribing to our newsletter to give you updates and membership-specific content. Visit www.cityprepping.com/newsletter or click on the link in the description and comments section below to subscribe today. Enjoy the video. The concept of election night is no longer accurate. The space between the casting of the first votes actually in mid-September through inauguration date on January 20th was always to allow for an accurate and thorough counting of votes and to allow any newly appointed president enough time to travel from their state and transition to their duties in Washington, D.C. Though many think a clear winner is projected on an election night, that always isn't the case. In fact, it has become increasingly unlikely. This year's state lockdowns might hamper access to polling places, mail-in voting might be more widespread than ever due to the pandemic and might suffer from fraud. Foreign governments might try to hack into state electoral systems or even try to clandestinely start riots in cities to dissuade turnout. In addition, votes might prove so close that reliable and accurate recounts cannot occur in time. Under the Constitution, Congress sets a date of the election, November 3rd of this year. The Constitution also establishes a deadline for states to send in their electoral votes, which is December 14th of this year. Even with a landslide clear projected winner, the disruption between any peaceful transition of power or the continuation of power from the current administration already looks to be not guaranteed. 78 days is a long time for chicanery, chaos, executive orders, media narratives, political leaders encouraging supporters to take up arms, congressional acts, court cases, accusations, blame games, and protests that are met with heavy-handed federal responses. If there is a crisis, events will unfold quickly, and sleep-deprived leaders will be asked to make consequential decisions quickly. With that being said, let's examine five possible scenarios and outcomes that might play out beginning November 3rd. Scenario number one, no clear winner in the morning. The worst possible scenario of the five covered here is that there isn't a clear projected winner on the morning of November 4th. The power of Congress to navigate such a crisis might be compounded by its own uncertainty of which party will assume power. Typically, new congressional members are sworn in within the first 10 days of January as outlined in the Constitution. But in a closed congressional outcome, and in the days following an election where both presidential candidates claim power, the smooth transition of government isn't guaranteed. In the event of a close race that's unclear in the morning, there will be calls for recounts in some states. There will be efforts to halt the counting of mail-in ballots or efforts to stop the counting of ballots and declare a winner. Either party may seek to misrepresent the facts and cast aspersions on the process. There will be efforts to turn out the party's base to the streets. There will be media spin echoing and amplifying the chaos and forcing the American population to pressure leadership to take action and deliver an outcome. There could be organized work strikes and stoppages. There may be actions by the federal government to quell violence, force outcomes, or even seize mail-in ballots to ensure state officials stop counting ballots. In a time where chaos boils over in the streets in the hours after some events, what will 78 days of uncertainty and anger bring? You have to prepare now for a possible long-term lockdown for at least these 11 weeks. If the streets are not safe, food supply lines are stymied, stores may be looted by opportunistic individuals taking advantage of chaos for their own gain. Fire and police services may be occupied and engaged elsewhere when you need them. Water and power might even be knocked offline for a long period of time. Scenario number two, Joe Biden clearly wins the popular and electoral college votes. In the event of a clear margin win of both the popular and electoral college votes by Joe Biden, Americans may still be spun into an extended period of chaos. While traditionally, a transition team is formed and works with an outgoing administration to effect a peaceful, constructive, and informed transition of power, there is no guarantee that the current president will accept the results of a Joe Biden victory. The current administration could use its 78 remaining days in office to contest election results, ignore election results, or even adopt some type of poison pill strategy to completely prevent the possibility of a transition of power. Already, from allegations of voter suppression to claims of voter fraud, seeds of chaos are being planted by both sides. A Joseph Biden win could pave the way for inquiries into the actions of the Trump administration, possible further litigation and judgments. Donald J. Trump would assuredly use his position for the remaining 78 days to guarantee himself immunity from further investigations or prosecution. What measures might he take, and what repercussions might those efforts have? Is a peaceful transition of power guaranteed in a clear Joseph Biden victory, given what we have already witnessed today? Scenario number three, Donald Trump wins the electoral vote but loses the popular vote. Similar to the 2016 election and the 2000 election, it's an increasing probability that a candidate can lose a popular vote and still win an electoral vote. In 2000, we saw some courthouses overrun and small pockets of chaos. In 2016, we saw a post-election protest of thousands and thousands of people taking to the streets. What could 2020 bring in an already conflicted and tumultuous environment? In the previous two elections where this scenario played out, we also didn't have riots, looting, or armed civilians in the streets. Now, some elements of the armed right are taken to the streets to face protesters. Some on the left see this election as the last chance to stop a rapid and potentially irreversible U.S. decline into authoritarianism and unbridled nativism, and have already taken to the streets. Amid these two very divergent sides, opportunistic fomenters of chaos on both sides are advocating for the destruction of the U.S. government establishment altogether. The result has been looting, riots, arson, and altercations that seem to get worse and worse, more deadly and destructive every day. Absent a call for unity, could a spark by either side detonate a power keg of death and destruction across America? An election by the Electoral College without the results matching the popular vote could be such a spark. It is far from a guarantee of a peaceful outcome. A conflict between these votes could create an atmosphere to further contest election results or processes. And again, these conflicts could boil over into cities and towns across America. States with distinct party control could choose to stop vote counting or forcibly continue vote counting against the federal government's mandates. As states rebel from federal will, is another civil war possible? At the very least, these conflicts and altercations could lead to a constitutional crisis, judicial rulings, and congressional battles. They could result in 11 or more weeks of chaos swirling around you and your peaceful neighborhoods. Scenario number four, Joe Biden wins electoral and popular votes by narrow margins. A Joseph Biden victory, but with narrow margins, would assuredly result in a significant spin and pushback from the current administration. The current administration has floated the ideal that any close race may not be accepted, and we have seen how the mainstream media and fringe news outlets can sow division and stoke the fires of confusion. A narrow margin win, really, by either candidate, would lead to chaos and could lead to violence. There is a significant possibility of simultaneous street mobilizations by both Trump and Biden supporters, in which case the possibility for violence will increase significantly, and the actions of law enforcement will become critical. Significant opportunities for government overreach and seize of your power as a citizen can be done in the name of quote-unquote restoring order or quote-unquote protecting property. Given a narrow Biden victory, would the Trump administration focus on their own self-preservation, quickly rush to pardon everyone by resigning early and letting the vice president hastily pardon everyone, or even spark a foreign conflict to divert attention away from contested results? Would an outgoing administration destroy potentially incriminating evidence or seek to disrupt the transition process? Nobody can really know with any certainty how either parties will act in a narrow margin victory. Nobody has a crystal ball for this one, but studied experts with far more experience than you and I with these matters are unanimously concluding that we're in for a very, very rocky road. Scenario number five, Donald Trump wins electoral and popular votes by narrow margins. Though there may be many scenarios that we can't fully cover in this video, another probable outcome is a Donald Trump win above the electoral and popular votes. Though a landslide might also be possible, if there is any validity to any of the polls, a win would likely be more by narrow margins. So that's what we'll look at here. After the 2016 election, thousands of citizens poured out into the streets, upset that their popular vote did not coincide with the Electoral College. Even with a clear win of both votes, it would be reasonable to assume that the same outpouring of citizenry would occur. The difference this year, however, is that there is already protests in the streets. Unemployment is at an all-time high and benefits are expiring while rents and mortgages are becoming increasingly overdue. Government is still quite divisive, but in 2020, parties seem to have stopped trying to work together at all, and the people are more disillusioned and apt to anger. What happens when an angry, hungry, and poor population pours out onto the streets and is met by a president who ran on a platform of law and order countering with heavily armed federal forces? Also in 2020, we have already witnessed a president who feels comfortable pulling federal funding if he believes it is necessary from democratically governed states. If states held up vote counting or refuse to stop vote counting at the hest of the Department of Justice and the president, is it possible that the president might halt the flow of federal funding to those states? Could these states that retaliate by halting the flow of money into the federal coffers? This scenario with just two states could reveal an even greater conflict. The democratically run states of California and New York make up 22% of gross domestic product and 18% of the United States population. Are we at a point where the federal government will trounce state autonomy or states will toy with the ideal of secession? We don't really know, but if 2020 has taught us anything, it is to expect that anything can happen. So I don't think we can rule the possibility out. There are far more possibilities and scenarios in the five discussed here. The possibility of a hostile foreign country or terrorist organization detonating explosives and leaving both parties pointing the finger of blame at each other, but keeping people away from the polls was explored here. But foreign agitators remain a possibility. Our nation's enemies aren't taking a break to let us have a peaceful vote. Voting machine hacking, the intentional destruction of ballots, or people intentionally voting both by mail and in person was explored here either. There are countless scenarios, and we have only explored five likely possible scenarios. None of them seem to end well, so you need to be aware of how this can jeopardize your safety and threaten your survival in the immediate future. If voting is important to you and you don't trust the mail system right now, consider completing a ballot and taking it in person to your county election office days before November 3rd. This will keep you safe from any chaos in the streets on election day. Do plan for a contested election right up to and possibly even after January 20th. There likely will not be an election night winner, and neither party is going into this election willing to accept defeat. The 78 days between election night and inauguration could undo over 240 years of America's nation building. Before food supplies and distribution methods are jeopardized, make sure your supplies are in order. Make sure you have a means to store and purify drinking water. Make sure you have a means to produce heat for winter if you live in colder climates. Prepare now for what is shaping up to be the most volatile election in our lifetimes. If you found this video informative, please feel free to share on social media. If you have any thoughts or feedback, please post those in the comments section below, as I typically try to read those and respond within the first hour. As always, stay safe out there.